In this Ledger Nano S tutorial, I'm going to show you how to physically set up your device step by step while also showing all the possible benefits and security features. Then I will show you how to set up your Ledger Live app the correct way and then connecting it to MetaMask to make transactions. So make sure to stick with me till the end. We're now ready to set up our device, and what you'll need is Ledger Nano S, our USB cable, and our 24-word recovery sheet. So now you'll open up your Ledger. So you plug in your USB to your computer and then your micro USB into your Ledger Nano S. This powers on your Ledger Nano S and takes you to the welcome screen. Don't worry about some of the glitch on the screen, it's just from the video recording. But I assure you that the real thing has no issue. So I'll quickly explain to you the controls of the Ledger Nano S. If you can see here, they only come with two buttons. The left button is usually when you want to go backwards. The right button is when you want to go forward or right. And to double tap is to press OK or enter. So from here, we would run a right click to continue and keep continuing until it says set up as new device. And if you right click one more time, it will set up your device from an existing recovery phrase. If you want to recover your wallet, then you want to skip to the next step where I show you how to do this. Otherwise, come back to set up as new device and double tap to press enter. Now we want to choose our PIN, double tap again. For this case, I'm just going to choose 1111. And you would keep tapping left to bring the digit down to 1, then double press to enter, and we would do the same. If you want to raise the number up, you would press the right button until it gets to your number. Once you're happy, then you would double tap one more time, and now we would have to confirm our PIN one more time. Hit confirm. Now this is where you have to write down your 24-word seed phrase into your sheet here. Now we press both buttons to continue. And here's our first word, is usage. Now I write these 24 words down. Don't get any ideas to try and access my wallet with this address because it's not gonna work. I'm only using this as an example in this video to help you out. There'll be no funds in this wallet for you. Now that we have recorded down our 24 words, we'll click next and confirm our recovery phrase. This is a tedious process, but we're gonna have to confirm a few words again. So the first word is usage, so I'll double tap that. The second word is fame, so I'll double tap that. So we have to do this one by one until we get to the 24th word to confirm to Ledger that we have recorded down our recovery phrase correctly. Now that our recovery phrase is set, we want to right tap again, until we get to the press both buttons to continue. And there we go, our device is now ready and we can move on to the next step. So now you'll find out why this 24 word seed phrase is so important to keep away safe somewhere and don't share to anyone. But by the way, sharing a like on this video is safe and secure, I promise. So feel free to do that. In this step, I'm going to show you how to set up your wallet by recovering your seed phrase into a new Ledger Nano S. And you would do this by holding both buttons down at the same time and going into settings, security, and then we would click on reset device, entering our PIN. Now we're back to the factory settings at the beginning, and we can go right to where it says restore from recovery phrase, and then double tap that, choose our PIN, double tap it again, and I will select 1111 like in the previous step. Confirm with the same PIN again. Now here comes the tedious part. You're gonna need to use all 24 recovery words and enter them in one by one into the Ledger Nano S here. There's also a choice of the 18 word recovery phrase and the 12 words. This can be, for example, if you wanna migrate from your MetaMask wallet into your Ledger Nano S, then you would use the 12 words. I don't recommend you do this because the whole point of having a cold storage wallet is to keep it offline, whereas something like your MetaMask is an online hot wallet. So putting that on your Ledger sort of defeats the purpose. So go back to your 24 words, hit enter, and now we would enter in our first word. Hit enter again. So my first word is usage. So I would left click until I get to the letter U, double tap the button to enter, find the S, double tap to enter. And now after entering the first two or three letters, it's gonna help you out and let you choose between a few words. You can see here, they have different words for you to choose to help speed up your recovery step. So now usage is the right one, so I double tap here. And now I would do this for the rest of the 24 words. Now, once you're done with your 24 word seed phrase, it's going to process and shows that your device is now ready. And that means we're ready to move on to the next step. The next step is to install our Ledger Live app. And we can do that by going to ledger.com/start. And then you can come to this section here and click on download and choose your operating system. For me, it's Windows app, so I'm going to click on that. And once your download is complete, we'll install the program. Click finish, and here's our Ledger Live app ready to get started. So now we would click here, agree to their terms of service, and then enter the Ledger app. Now choose your device. In this case, it's the Nano S, and you'll be presented with three different options. You can set up your new device or recover your old device if you have the seed phrase, which we did in the previous step. And lastly, you can just connect to your Nano S, which we're going to do here because our device is already set up. Click continue, and now click on check my Nano just to make sure it's a genuine version. And now we're going to have to agree to this on our Ledger Nano S by double tapping the buttons here. Okay, I've been verified. Now you can click on continue. Now the first thing I recommend you do before you go on and do anything else is to update your software on both your Ledger hardware device and the Ledger Live app. So you can see here in the note, it says there's a newer version available. So I'm going to download the update and install that right away. And now after updating the Ledger Live version, it's also prompted me to update the firmware on my hardware device. So now I'm going to follow them and go to manager, confirm that you have your recovery phrase, click continue. And now we'll have to go to our Ledger device and right tap, and then followed by a double tap to confirm this update. Now you need to re-enter in your PIN to unlock your device. And there it is, our firmware has been updated correctly. Just a quick tip here, I always recommend you connect your Ledger device to your Ledger Live app every month or two to update the firmware. Because if you don't use it for a while, let's say 6 months to 12 months, and Ledger has gone through a few iterations of the update, then it may be a hassle for you to have to reset your device. There's been a fair few complaints about this from Ledger users that this problem has occurred to them when they don't use a device for a long time. So that's just something you might want to consider doing. Now, the next thing I strongly recommend you do is to lock your Ledger Live app. So you can do this by going to settings and then enable the password lock feature. Now we've put in our password, click save. This is standard practice to keep your account safe, so make sure you do that. Next, I want to show you how to add crypto coins and install them to your Ledger Live app. So we go back to Manager and we can pick the coins we want to install. So for this example, I'm going to go Bitcoin and Ethereum. You can see here the Ledger Nano S is quite small, so you're only going to be able to fit two or three coins on here. And now that both of these cryptocurrencies have been installed, we want to go and create a wallet address for them. So we can do that by going to Portfolio, and then click on Add Account. Now we want to choose the asset. In this case, I'm going to choose Bitcoin and click on Continue. Now I'm going to have to double tap on my Ledger Nano S to accept this. And now I can click on Add Account. Click Done. And now I can go to my account. And you will see here, there's my Bitcoin wallet created successfully. So now that we've set all this up, we're ready to test out this wallet and make some transactions. So now I'm going to show you how to send and receive coins in and out of your wallet. So to receive Bitcoin into this newly created wallet of mine, I'm going to have to go to receive, select the address that I want, which is the Bitcoin One wallet. Now click on continue. Now click on copy. And now I'll verify that address on my Ledger Nano S, making sure that it matches the Ledger Live app, and then double tap to confirm. Now click done. And now that we've copied the address, we need to send some Bitcoin over to this wallet. And if you need to buy some off an exchange, then I strongly recommend you use FTX. FTX is my number one recommended crypto exchange right now that I use myself. And if you don't have an account yet, want to sign up, then feel free to use my link here to get a discount and reduce your fees on all your trades. So now I'm going to go to my Bitcoin account and click on withdraw and enter in the amount I want. And under the BTC address, I'm going to paste in the address that I copied from the Ledger Live app. Now for the withdrawal method, click BTC. And now we have to enter in our two-factor authentication code. And once you've done that, then click on withdrawal. And now we can go back to our Ledger Live app, wait a few minutes for your funds to arrive. And now we can see that our funds have successfully arrived into our wallet. Now the next step is to send Bitcoin to another wallet. And we can do this by clicking on send. Now we would enter the address that we want to send to, click on continue, put in the amount that we want. Now we can choose the fee we want to spend. It's preset at medium, which is 8 sats, or you can click fast, or if you're not in a rush to send or receive your money, then you can choose slow. I mean, click on continue. And if you agree with the amount and the network fees, then you can click continue again. Then double tap your device to confirm and send. It's that simple. Now the next and very important step I want to show you is how to connect your Ledger wallet to MetaMask to do anything DeFi online. So in this example, I'm going to use the Matic chain, which is part of the Ethereum network. So I'll first have to create an Ethereum wallet, and I can do that again by going to accounts, then click on add account, and I'll select Ethereum, click on continue, double tap my Ledger, confirm, wait for it to sync, then click on add account. Click done. So now we'll need to go to metamask.io. Then you need to download and set up your MetaMask account. If you don't know how to do this, I'll leave a video tutorial link explaining you how to do this step by step. Now I'm going to open my MetaMask account by clicking here and then clicking on this three dots and click on expand view. This is going to open a new page for you where you can work on your account much easier. And the first thing we're going to do is to connect our Ledger Live app to MetaMask. And you can do this by clicking here, then click on Connect Hardware Wallet, choose Ledger, click Connect, click on your Nano S, and then click Connect. And now you want to choose the wallet to connect to. And just to double check, we're going to go back to our Ledger Live, click on the Ethereum wallet, click Receive, click Continue. And we can see here our wallet ends in 4381 and starts at 0x777. And from this list, it's the first one. Now click on Unlock. And then you have to verify the address on your Ledger Nano S by tapping right until the very end. And then once you get to the approve page, then double tap it. And there's our wallet, 0x77, ending in 4381, connected to your MetaMask. So now we're able to receive and send funds. So I want to first receive some Matic into my Ledger wallet. So I'm going to copy the address here, go back to my original wallet, and then I'm going to go send. Put in our Ledger Nano S wallet address, and then I'm going to send 0.1 Matic. Now click next, I'll confirm the fees, and then send. And now I can go back to our Ledger Nano S wallet, which is here, and in a few moments, you should see 0.1 Matic here. And there it is, very quick, our funds have arrived. So now we're able to send money out of our Ledger Nano S. And then I'm going to show you how to do this now. We're going to click on send. And then I'm going to paste in the original address where the money came from. And I'm only going to send back 0.05 this time. Just so you can see how much money is left. Now click next. Confirm the gas fee. Check everything is okay and the total amount is correct. And then click on continue. And then we have to review the transaction on our Ledger device again. And now we'll review it, check the address and the amount. And if it's all correct, then we're going to go to the accept and send by double tapping here. And now it's going to send. Give it a few moments for the transaction to complete. And then you'll see the account balance is 0.0494. We sent out 0.05, but plus the gas fee, and that's what's left. This is very simple and easy if you follow the method step by step on how to do this. Now, a few more features of the Ledger Live worth mentioning is that they have an exchange platform where you can convert cryptos like Bitcoin into Ethereum if you want to. So this may come in handy for you later. And they also have a discovery section where you can start to do things like DeFi right on the Ledger Live app instead of having to go to the Google Chrome or Internet Explorer. For example, 1inch, you can connect to that right here and make transactions. So this is also a cool added feature for you. Now, if you're looking for more information on this Ledger Nano S, and I've done an in-depth review here, which you can check out. Or if you're looking for an alternative to the Ledger Nano S, then I've got this video showing you which hardware wallet I recommend. So check it out, and I'll see you over in that next tutorial.